So you're already learned that I am a linguist, not a historian like many of you, or all of you, many of you.
Few of us.
And this is important because my path to the Geniza studies came through Semitic languages, including Judeo-Arabic, and only then I came to do some work which is more philological and broader. So this is the topic, early Geniza fragments of Sargent Owen's translation of the Pentateuch, and the goals of my project. First, to identify the early Geniza fragments of Sadia, the Owen's translation of the Pentateuch. Second, to provide their complete readings. Third, compare with the major representatives of Sadia's translation of the Pentateuch in Hebrew and Arabic script. And to provide philological analysis of these fragments, that is, early versions, orthography, language, translation techniques. The first tool, or the first goal, and then the first tool for this goal. So it is primarily the Friedberg Geniza project. It is already known that we have to start there. That's the starting point. So, how do I do it? I was lucky to spend 6 months sabbatical in Princeton. Maybe that's the opportunity to thank Mark and Marina for sponsoring several short visits of mine to Princeton, and Martha even for sponsoring my sabbatical there. And I was lucky to find there all the JTS collection. We just moved temporarily there. So this was, actually, I prepared myself carefully for the work on the JTS collection in advance. I identified 26 fragments through an automatic search through the website, the Friedberg Geniza project website. I checked them carefully. I read them, and I was going to work on them with the original. When I came to the end of my sabbatical, I had not 26 fragments, but 180 fragments, which I completely read and worked on. So how come? From where do we have this gap in numbers? It's about book 7. And I come here to the problem that we already met today in other presenters' words. The problem was that when I looked in the automatic search for Saadia's translation, I found only 26. But when I started checking the material, the other material, I occasionally found other fragments. So I just knew that I had to check them more carefully. And then it seems to happen that the tagging was not good enough. Some fragments were tagged as Aramaic, some as Hebrew Bible, some as some kind of Arabic tafsir or Arabic translation, and some other tags over there. So I had to check all of them, which came to be thousands of fragments to check from. It was really hard work, and why does it happen with Saadia's translation? Because many of the fragments contain not only the Arabic translation, but Hebrew and Arabic translation in Midland, or Hebrew, Aramaic, and Arabic translation in Midland, or just Aramaic and Arabic translation in Midland. And they were marked as either Hebrew, Arabic tafsir, sometimes only Aramaic. It depends on the interest of the scholar who checked them first, before me. So it was really hard just to find all the fragments and work on them. So the identification of Saadia's translation was really hard. It is harder than I thought. And it will end in probably thousands of fragments. A lot more than I previously assumed. Next, I have to identify what is early among these fragments. So I have first to see what is Sardius, and then to see what is early out of Sardius. And here actually came to my help Dr. Mitchell, which we all know, and his expertise in name writing, Arabic scripts, helps me to know what is early and what is later. I'm grateful to him. The next stage is to provide complete readings of the fragments. So, as to the reading of the Nisa fragments themselves, I have learned that the fragments available in the website of the Research Nisa project should better be rechecked and compared with the original. There are certain features that can be observed only in the Nisa site, but others can be checked and observed only in the original. So you really have to work on both. You can be satisfied with just half of the work, either on the site or with the original. In addition, there is still a large amount of fragments, especially from St. Petersburg, which is not there. So I have to find my way to these fragments in a different way. Now I have to compare with the fragments, the readings of the fragments, with the many representatives of Sa'adia's translation of the Gemara. So we know of two major branches of translation of Sa'adia's tafsir. The first branch is in Hebrew script, and the main manuscript is manuscript St. Petersburg from the Russian National Library. Unfortunately, it is not complete. Certain parts are missing, so we have to go to other manuscripts, and those from Oxford are the best to look at for now, for the beginning of the 15th century. And we still use their book edition. It is outdated, but still useful, so we can go to it too. Another branch is in Arabic script, and here you have all the major representatives of the Arabic transmission, Coptic transmission, other Christian adaptations, basically from Syria, from the Peter tradition, and perhaps also some Geniza fragments that are Karaite, and here I am indebted to the one in Poland, who gave me the list of the other Christian adaptations and his work on the other fragments. Letters. Obviously, the most important for my work is the manuscripts and editions in Hebrew script. But I will probably check also the branch in Arabic characters. So this is it. And finally, I have to work on the philological analysis, that is to see what are the early versions, to check orthography, to check language, that is mainly vocabulary and syntax, and to check translation techniques. It looks like it is the final stage, but actually I should do it constantly with the other work, because it also helps to identify the early versions. So it's not just the final stage. I constantly have to check not just the script in order to know what is early and what is late, but to compare it with other versions, etc. So, it's about cooperation, this session. So how can we cooperate on this project? Those of you who are fortunate enough to teach to their marketing class, I am, by the way, not so fortunate. If you like, you can give your students fragments to read, and I can, on my part, provide lists of such fragments. It will help me if they provide provisional readings that I can work on, and of course, exchange of students is always welcome. Pleasant.
Madame, thank you very much. Questions for Mark Kent?
Here when we talk about humility, you compare, you try to find the early versions. In the beginning, we use always the word original, compared to the original.
Yeah. What I mean by original? I actually mean by the texts themselves, not the copies, the digital copies that we find in the Fraser-Tunisa project or in other projects, teams of the National Library and others. So the original is just the text itself.
That's it. Okay. And as a philologist, what would you say comparing the historical research about the early and the later versions? You find difference in the results, or they are the same?
No, there are differences. Actually, that's the reason why we...
Could you give an example that what was considered late or earlier, according to philologist research, is the opposite?
Well, I didn't bring here fragments to show you because it was about the project in general, not specific details.
Okay.
But we already know, even before we use a material I tried to work with it and so forth, we already know that there are differences when we use St. Peter's books and the manuscript that I just mentioned. You see differences between it and their book edition and other later editions. The differences are not large. They are usually small in vocabulary and syntax and so on. So it's not a major scale of differences. It's not a different manuscript, but we see a gradual change in the versions. And I can already say, according to what I worked, to my previous work and so forth, that diversity of the versions in small details is larger, it's wider than we previously knew.
Quick, you, Phil, do you want to ask a question?
Yeah, please. Thank you for this discussion, this interesting project. Could you share some of the findings with respect to orthography? And if there is a trajectory over time in orthography?
Yes, of course there is. Yeah, that's one thing that I have to look at in the beginning, not at the end of the project, because use of diacritics developed for the years. So the early fragments have less diacritics than the later ones.
What about,
so it's one of the signs that something is early.
Did you see anything in terms of divergences from classical Judeo-Arabic spelling?
Yes, of course. Some of the earliest versions have some varieties of this type of script as well. And also in language, of course, in terms of linguistic proximity with classical Arabic. The early versions are more close to classical Arabic than the later ones. And this is clear.
But specifically with respect to the orthography.
Yeah. Well, most of them are Saadian, which means it means that they already use the Saadian system. So it's not dramatic, but we do see some differences, and there are also branches that we can trace. The Yemenite branch, for example, uses always Tzadi with a dot, either for Bo and for Vo. While the other versions differentiate between them and use the Tzadi with a dot and the Tet with a dot. So there are differences that we knew of from other manuscripts, not just from the Guinness material, but it shows the same process of writing, which was in two different branches in Hindu script. The Arab script is another question.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.